Hello everyone, welcome to this quick tips about Arnold for Cinema 4D. This one is going to be about some pools in Arnold and the places where you can deal with some pools. So you can deal with some pools basically inside of the Arnold settings themselves. So you have the diffuse samples, the glossy samples, the refraction samples, the subsurface samples, and the volume indirect samples. They're all multiplied by the camera samples, the anti-aliasing samples. So if I multiply this value, as you can see, the samples of all the other components are as well multiplied. So I can keep this by at the default settings for now. Let me close this window. And so my scene is a simple sphere and a cube. I'm going to create some light. Alright, and this is the second place where we can have samples on the light. So if I go here, you can see that we have a sample of 1 by default because, let me just plug in my IPR right there. If I have no samples, the lights won't get calculated. So put 1 here. Let's just bring the exposure up a little bit. Alright, something like that. And as you can see, it's pretty noisy right now. So I could, for instance, up those samples to, let's say, 4. And I'll lose most of the diffuse noise. I can actually try to put it higher. And it's going to bog down the renderer and not especially clear the noise. Okay? So you have to really understand what kind of samples affect which kind of noise. But this is not the subject of this tutorial. The subject is more of where can we deal with samples. And the last place we can deal with samples is in on the materials themselves. So if I create, for instance, an Arnold surface here, apply it to my sphere. Now let's actually, let's dim down this light. So something like -1, so we still have a little bit of light, but not too much. I'm going to put the samples back to 1. And let's now create some emissive shader. So I'm going to go into my network editor, and let's, for instance, plug it here. Okay, let's plug that here. And let's say we want to create some noise. I'm going to create a flow noise. Right there, and apply it to the beauty. Okay, so this is flat mapping, which is what I want. Okay, I already have my UVs. I forgot that I had UVs. I have simple flat UVs on this sphere. So, okay, now if I just take my flow noise and get an higher intensity, an higher frequency, sorry. Not that high, but something like that. This is going to be cool. And let's, for instance, apply that as a normal map and as well as a light source for our emission shader. So if I go and put that into the displacement, now it's going to displace that. I just need to add an Arnold parameter to control it. So I'm going to put the height to 5 and I'm going to tick all of them. And then let's have 3 subdivisions here. Pretty perfect. I can even lower down these settings to 3. This is cool. All right. Now let's take a layer color, for instance. So I'm going to create a layer color. One thing you have to know about layer color is that it is working the other way around. So this is the first layer, and this is the last layer. So let's take the flow noise and put it into the layer 7, for instance. And let's put the layer 7, let's plug this into the beauty itself so we can see this in a flat. As you can see, it's black because by default, all the alpha values are 0. So if I want to see what I put into the layer 7, I got to put the alpha at 1. Pretty simple, pretty simple. Now I could put a color here, for instance, and put this to 1, and change the blending mode to, let's say, overlay. and now this will create this share. But instead of using an input color like that, I want to use an utility shaders, for instance. So this is going to be a bit more flexible for later use. So here I can put, for instance, red, and I want to use a flat mode. And this is going to be not layer 7, sorry. It's going to be layer 8 color. Okay, so by now I just inputted red, so it's doing exactly the same thing as if we put red on the layer here. But one cool thing is I can use the all the other attributes here. So for instance, let's say I want to use it in the color mode, I want to use OBG, so OBG, and if I have many different, let's just duplicate that. If I have many different objects, each object will have its own color, as you can tell right there. Okay, pretty nice. So just create another one and another one. Okay, something like that. And let me just put this maybe, yeah, something like that. All right, so what I wanted to talk about, the last places where we can deal with samples, it's the shader themselves. As you can see here, I have my floor is pretty noisy, but I don't have any noise on my spheres because they are emitting and basically are black on the other side. So what we need to do, what we can do is get some greater sample generally. So I'm going to push this to 6, for instance, and at 6 I think it's going to clear that pretty much entirely. Let's maybe go up to 8. With the compression you might not see, but I still have a lot of noise here. And here too, I still have a lot of noise. So one last thing we can do is, and let me actually close that, so put that back to the default value too. One other thing we can do, and what we're going to do here, is we can change the material samples. But you don't want to change the material samples of the emissive shader, but of the one that receives the emission. So if I go here, create an normal surface, AL surface, I'm going to create another one. So this is going to name things up a little bit. This is going to be our emissive. Yeah, emissive. Emissive, and this is going to be our receiver. Just really lame name for now, but just so you get this. And now we're going to my network, and I can just go to the add the diffuse tab and advanced, and use the extra symbols right here. And if I put this to, let's say, 5, for instance, to start with, and and apply that to the cube. Yeah, by default it's gonna have a little specular. Let me remove the specular. As you can see, we're now doing the same thing as we did when we were increasing the diffuse samples generally, but only on this shader now. Okay, so we have the same value, but now it's pretty much noiseless. We could increase this value a little bit more and get something that extends a little bit. So this is really useful to understand where the samples are used in Arnold, where you can tweak them, and depending on the scene, to just analyze what kind of noise is produced, why can't the image quality be obtained. And generally, if you understand all those principles, you can get really, really, really amazing renders out of Arnold and really fast. And because that's why, when I first released the tutorials about light groups, I received a few people sent me scenes, Maya scenes containing the setup and everything, and I was supposed to look only at the light group thing, but I realized really quickly that the scenes were really bugged down either by not using text textures or either by not understanding which samples to put high, and some guy had all of his lights by default, 5 samples each light, and so this is not a good way to work. You should always have samples at 1 by default on everything, and then you just increase depending on your needs. So this was the first quick tip of the series, and let's see you guys in the next one. Bye bye.